please welcome Josh O'Connor, Mike Feist, and Zendaya. Look at you three sitting there. You look like you could be the new hosts of the project.
Yeah, we'd love to. Yeah.
Zendaya, trios are pretty tricky because one person is always left out. I know the feeling. These guys, they've got a whole bromance going on. What's the friendship dynamic like between you three in real life?
So far, so good, I'd say.
It's great.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, definitely.
Yeah, for sure. No, I'm definitely lucky to be partnered with these guys. I think from the beginning, whether it be working through the scripts together or tennis or whatever, I think everybody really had each other's back and feel super supported. So, yeah, I think we got a good group.
Well, congrats on challenges. But Tashi, she comes in and breaks up your friendship, boys. So I've got to ask, what happened to the bro code there?
The bro code.
The bro code.
Yeah, I guess we didn't get that memo, did we? Oh, we've got a sort of bro code.
In real life, we've got a great bro code. Yeah, I suppose she sort of, she sort of tears apart. We tear ourselves apart.
Yeah.
Mm. We're all as awful to each other as each other.
Have you ever busted up with a mate over a girl in real life?
No.
No.
Well answered.
Couldn't use that for inspiration
we really
here.
Find our own way. Yeah.
Josh, let me ask you this. The thing with sporting films is that very often the sport just looks terrible because the actors can't actually play. But the consensus here is that the tennis looks amazing. Mm-hmm. Look, you've really pulled it off. How did you manage to do that?
I do not know. To be honest, you know what? We worked really hard at trying to look like tennis players. Mike does look like a tennis player. He won't admit it, but he legit was the best. Was the best.
Oh, you mean when he plays? I thought you meant like his face just is a tennis player's face or something.
Well, that as well. But Mike's actually a good tennis player. Zendaya was like unbelievable at copying her double and so got that down. I just did it with a prayer. And in all honesty, had the best double who was like amazing. And I think probably they use my double more than anyone else.
Well, Josh, I wanted to talk about your serve because I don't want to rip it apart, but it's quite unique. I know it's a bit of a plot point, but you start like behind your head. Was that you or were you instructed to do that?
Oh, no, I was instructed to do that.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. We were trying to find, I mean, in the script, it's scripted that he has a kind of particular serve. And obviously, if you've seen the film, that serves a purpose.
Yeah.
But,
serves a purpose. Oh. Hey.
and so we looked at lots of footage to try and find a kind of unique serve. Oh. The problem is that unless you're like really in on tennis, like we had this coach, Brad Gilbert, who's a brilliant coach and was a brilliant tennis player, and he would show us videos and be like, look how weird this serve is. And we'd all be like,
looks
like a normal serve. But they're very slight differences, but no, that's not how I serve.
With someone like Brad Gilbert training you, like he's used to training superstars, now he's training people who, by your own admission, hadn't really played tennis before. Did he have to adjust?
Yeah. I think so. Yeah. I think so. He did. I don't think he realized, like, at least for me, I have never played tennis before. So I was a real, real newbie. And I think he realized kind of day one, he was like, oh, we're really starting from scratch. Like, you don't even understand. He really, you know, trying to explain the game and everything. But there is, like, such a kindness. Like, he's so sweet. He's such a nice man and made everybody feel comfortable no matter how our various tennis levels might have been.
This is a really sexy film. And, Josh, you have said that the tennis is the sex in this film. What do you mean by that?
Wow, that got around quick.
Yeah,
I feel like
did.
I said that this morning.
5 minutes ago.
I mean, I guess it is because, I mean, in this scenario, these three people have, like, their connection is each other, but it comes from the root of tennis. You know, Patrick and Art fall in love with Tashi, watching her play tennis. You know, Tashi, it feels like Tashi's trying to, we're all searching to bring that feeling together of when, you know, they're up against each other playing tennis. So I think that is the sort of raciness between the three of them.
Hey, when you are doing a film like this, obviously your co-stars are a big deal and the chemistry between you. Zendaya, I've got to ask you about a rumour. Is it true that when you signed on, you were Googling, what is the crown?
I probably did that.
Yeah,
it sounds like Mike.
Yeah, it sounds more like Mike. No, I had seen The Crown.
Okay.
And upon reading it, I remember thinking to myself, I said, you know who would be great? And I was like, the guy from The Crown. Oh. And I became aware of his work, and it was Josh O'Connor, so, and here he is. So, manifesting, you know.
I wouldn't be surprised if Mike had to Google
literally
The Crown.
Google, yeah.
I did.
Boys, Josh and Mike, while I've got you, I want to get, you know, a little something out of this interview that I can take, you know, further on in my life. So much of this film, kind of the acting, you communicate without words, basically. It's a lot of kind of stern looks, kind of passionate looks. Do you guys think you could give me some tips on how to act without communicating using words?
Well, I would start by not talking.
You're not the first person who suggested that to me before.
And yeah, that is the first step. Doing it now.
That's pretty much it.
We just look.
Look intense.
Longingly.
The thing is that Mike's average, like, standard look is intense.
Yeah.
Oh.
Smoldering.
That's
look at it, look at it.
Yeah, look at that.
There you go.
I see it. I feel something. I've got goosebumps right now.
Zendaya, you wore some incredible outfits on the Dune Part 2 press tour. We've got a few of them here. Will you be leaning into that or a bit more tennis court at the premiere tonight?
Yeah, I think I've enjoyed over the past, like, experimenting with theme dressing and or just kind of fashion in general. I think it's really been an avenue of self-expression for me. I remember last time I was here, I was here for Greatest Showman, and I literally wore a butterfly dress. So it's fun to experiment through fashion, and I think for me, I think I'm going to have fun with my stylist, Law, just creating looks that are inspired by maybe not literally tennis. I'm not going to show up as a tennis ball or anything.
I'd love to see that.
But that are inspired by some of the themes and color palettes of the world that we've created here. So, yeah.
Well, we'd better let you run to the premiere. Challengers lands in cinemas on April the 18th. In the meantime, would you please thank Mike, Josh and Zendaya?
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.